Hello you guys and welcome to today's video. I am so excited to have you here. So in today's video, we are going to be doing MLM horror stories, as you guys know. I will also be testing out a new microphone. I'm trying out a few different microphones, so we will see how this one works. It's not really easy to conceal, but it is what it is. So let's get straight into the MLM horror stories for today. The first one is going to be a Younique MLM horror story. It says, "Hi Deanna, I love your channel and I feel like your videos have really opened up my eyes. I was in Younique for quite a while, so this will be long. Please don't use my name if you read this video. A little backstory on me. When I was 23, I was assaulted and it resulted in several injuries that prevented me from going to work. In July of 2014, a friend of mine added me to a Younique party. I had never heard of it, but the mascara looked really cool, so I thought I'd try it. I was in a really dark place in my life and feel like I was an easy target for MLMs. I was depressed and had no self-esteem with all the crap I had been through. I love the mascara and signed up originally for the discount. The upline, or my upline, actually lived about 40 minutes away from me, and she had a party for the team for everyone to see the product she had got at the convention. I have terrible social anxiety, but really wanted new friends, so I went. After that gathering, I was convinced that this could change my life if I would just try. Yeah, I was sucked in. I quickly was booking parties and selling like crazy. I hit my first promotion and thought, and how easy this money was. Getting prizes from my upline and the shoutouts really made me feel like I was important and finally doing something for my future. I went to every team training and team dinner that I could. I became convinced that I wasn't recruiting or advancing because I couldn't go to the convention for health and financial reasons. If I remember correctly, the convention was $350 plus travel, etc. I finally hit pink status in March of 2016. I got so much praise on how I was the example of never giving up no matter how long it takes, even with my health issues. I was shocked and bummed that my bonus was only $60 for busting my ass and honestly buying a bunch of crap I ended up just selling to customers at a discount. I didn't realize that I really and truly spent more than I made, way more than I made. My upline told me, okay, next month you're going blue. To me, I felt like, okay, now pink isn't good enough. Blue status meant doubling my team volume. It took me a year just to advance to blue. Because I got together with other girls on the team, I started hearing things that didn't seem right to me. A few of us went out to dinner and a few of them were elite status. One was green and the other was orange. They started talking about how they couldn't believe how much money they spent on that free trip that they had earned. I was confused because it was supposed to be a free trip, right? They told me that they spent over $2,000 in airfare for the trip. Plus, they spent more for their alcohol, etc., that was not included as part of the incentive. They also talked about how hard it is to maintain and keep their circle volume up. One of the girls talked about how much of a pay cut it is to advance to orange and how she missed her green paychecks. I went home and watched a few videos on the comp plan and how people moved out of the circle and no longer counted for the volume. I honestly was so brainwashed that it didn't really make me want to quit like it should have. What was a huge reality check for me was when I went to my first convention. I was so excited to finally be able to go. I was determined to go no matter what it took. Well, I was charged all of my convention for the ticket, the hotel, meals, everything, because honestly I was so broke. So she said she charged all of her conventions. Does that mean she put it on like a credit card? Because she said the ticket, the hotel, meals and everything, because I was so broke. I was convinced this would help me hit green and could get me out of debt once I was green. Well, convention was awful. It was way too much for my health issues and I felt left out because I couldn't go to the parties and do what the other girls were doing. At convention, they announced that every status could earn a car bonus. You just needed 2K in volume on your front line. They said they wanted everyone to earn the car bonus. I was so excited and thought that this would be my answer to my prayers. This was in August. The week following convention, I was in so much pain. I was exhausted. I felt like a zombie. I was having horrible migraines because I completely did way too much. November, I earned the car bonus and I was so proud of myself. In February, corporate announced that they were changing the qualifications for the car bonus. You had to have 2K in volume from your front line, but you also had to have at least one person in your first 60 days, and they had to have, I believe, $75 in PRs. I was so angry because I'm not big on recruiting and thought that they were such liars about wanting everyone to earn it. After that, I stopped to recruit because I felt like corporate wasn't looking out for their presenters. I was still in team chats and trying to work the business, but I started noticing that my uplines were encouraging us to buy every single shade of lipstick and eyeshadow, etc., and charge it if we don't have the funds right now. They would say they can demonstrate it and you'll get sales. So you'll get that money right back, plus everything is a tax write-off, right? One night we were in a team chat doing our end of the month push. My upline told me I was only two foundations away from my blue, or from maintaining blue. I told her I was aware, but I didn't need anything and neither did my customers. She encouraged me to buy a few mascaras and sell them later. That really rubbed me the wrong way because I'm on a fixed income with very high medical bills and I didn't want to spend $80 to get an extra 1% off my team volume. When I refused to do it, a girl on my team went and ordered a few things. I felt terrible and told her how unnecessary it was and that she didn't need to do that. She said no worries and I'll just resell it later. After that, I felt like I was really starting to see how brainwashed we all were. Soon after that, I did my taxes and I made something like $2,500, but I had spent $10,000. That crap about you'll get it back at tax time was a bunch of garbage. I spent way too much in the company that I ended up filing bankruptcy. Not all of it was Younique charges, to be fair, but I don't think I would have been in that much debt had I not joined the company. I'm sorry this is so long, but there's so much manipulation and shaming in that company that it truly does feel like cult mentality. Ugh. To me, this one is really shitty because clearly this is someone that had like a lot of health issues. And when it comes to someone who is struggling with mental health or just any issues in general, like any physical issues or mental health issues, you clearly see that these are people who get roped into these MLMs even more. And to me, it's really sad because as we could see with this person and her experience in this MLM, it was like nothing was ever enough, right? You would hit one rank and then you would go to hit another one and another one and another one and you would spend all this money, what, buying products or having your downline buy products or friends buy products or whatever, to the point where it's like that rank advancing isn't even worth it. Like she said, it's like rank advancing to blue, like going out and buying products that were $80+ just to rank advance to get what, 1% of a team volume, just wasn't worth it. And to me, I feel like this is like a huge thing in MLMs, is they'll do anything to get you to rank advance so that they can. So when it comes to most MLMs, when you look at most MLMs, you can't do things like rank advance or make more income unless your downline does work. And what I mean by your downline doing work, I mean them cold messaging, them recruiting, them buying product, all the way to having your team do everything because you need to rank advance. And if you actually take a look at most MLMs and you look up how to rank advance in these MLMs, most MLMs, the only way to rank advance is to have your team rank advance. So you end up having to have a team of a bunch of people. Those bunch of people have to rank advance, and that's the only way to get you to rank advance. So in these MLMs, when they say the income is, oh, your income is all based on you, finally, because you're not working in corporate where you're getting paid an hourly wage, you can now make as much or as little as you want. It's like, no, it's not up to you most of the time. Most of the time, it's like you have to convince your downline or have your downline work in order for you to get anywhere. And it's like, it's not all based on you. The second your downline quits or cancels their account, you're done. Like you lose your ranks and stuff like that. So it's just a really sad reality, and again, it's just a sad reality to see this person taken advantage of when, you know, she was struggling and going through so much. So the next MLM horror story says, MLM horror story, these companies are so unethical. So it says, hi Deanna, I hope you're doing well. For the following story, please keep me anonymous. First off, I want to start off by saying I think it's so wonderful that you're pursuing your psych degree. I actually graduated. Yeah, I just got my degree and I actually want to hang it up somewhere in here. I feel like it's a big accomplishment for me. She goes, I am a family therapist who works primarily with children, adolescents, and their families, and I started with an undergrad in psych. She said, anyway, on to the story. I wanted to reach out with an MLM horror story that occurred semi-recently. Actually, some may not consider it a traditional horror story as it didn't happen to me, but I was a witness of sorts to it. So there's a store where I go grocery shopping frequently. I'm at least there once a week. I either know or recognize most of the employees, especially the cashiers and attendants that help bag items. When I was there a few months ago, checking out my groceries, I recognized the attendant bagging my items from previous shopping trips. She was a young adult, I believe anywhere from 18 to 21 years old. And she is super sweet and personable. It is also apparent based on her demeanor, vocabulary, and conversational skills that she has some form of developmental delay. Of course, I am at no means attempting to diagnose her or assume anything about her abilities. However, like I mentioned earlier, I'm a therapist who has had a fair amount of training related to assessing cognitive performance and identifying these possible delays. So it is something that I'm able to pick up on. Anyway, she asked if she could help me to my car with my groceries, which I said yes to. I enjoy talking with her in general as she is very kind and cheerful, so I was glad to have sort of a short chat with her. So when we were walking in the parking lot to my car, I asked how she had been and what she was up to lately. She responded that she had recently gotten an insurance certificate and was going to be working in that field as a second job. Oh, she then said that it was through Primerica. My heart sank. She followed that information up with something along the lines of, quote, "a lot of people think it's a scam," unquote. I asked her what she thought about that. She was convinced that it was legitimate. She talked about a recent meeting that she had been to where one of the presenters was talking about how he made all this money through Primerica. I asked her if she was aware that in companies like that, she would need to recruit in order to make money. She said yes and went on to verify that she was told that recruiting was the best way to make money. I remained calm on the outside, but inside I was screaming. The fact that these companies are so predatory that they would stoop so low to take advantage of someone who's clearly so vulnerable is disgusting to me. I wanted to talk to her for a little longer about the dangers of MLMs, but she had to get back inside the store to finish her shift. Plus, I knew that if I started throwing statistics and warnings at her, she could possibly feel defensive and was shut down to the conversation. It was so heartbreaking. She's such a sweet, kind person, and it's so upsetting that someone looked at her and saw easy dollar signs instead of a person. These companies taking advantage of anyone is wrong, but it is extra unethical when the person in question is already vulnerable and unable to comprehend the full scope of what they may be getting into. I can only hope that she has a positive support system who will guide her into better choices and that won't result into her losing tons of money. Personally, I am torn on how or if I should address the situation with her further to see if I can further if I see her again at the grocery store. I'm thinking that if I get another chance to talk with her, I'll simply ask her experience with Primerica and how it's been going and go from there. Hopefully, she'll no longer be in that scam. By the way, I want to clarify that I'm in no way suggesting that people with developmental delays can't understand specific requirements. And I'm not saying that they can't be valuable employees and team members. All I'm saying is that for most people with these type of delays, information generally needs to be broken down and maybe presented in a way more concrete and basic, making it easier to comprehend quickly. Based on the conversation that I had with this girl, it was very obvious that she was unaware of the implications of what recruiting would entail and that whoever recruited her was most likely not at all upfront about the reality of being in an MLM. Anyway, I'll wrap it up here. Thank you so much for all you do, etc. Ugh, this is like a really crappy situation, but even the fact that this person, you know, stated, not the person who sent me the story, but the person who got stuck in the MLM stated the fact of like, oh, you know, whoever recruited me said that you have to recruit to make money. It clearly shows what? It shows, that's kind of the definition of what a pyramid scheme is, that you have to rely on recruiting, or recruiting is the main basis of where you make your money. But on top of that, I feel like sometimes MLMs don't really go fully into it. You know, like they don't go fully into what recruiting entails, what that means, and they may not educate about what an actual pyramid scheme is, because why would they want to? Because when you look at, oh, this MLM rep said that the only way to make money is to recruit, and then you look at the definition of a pyramid scheme or what the FTC says pyramid schemes are and how to look out for them, you're gonna be like, ain't that the same thing? So clearly this person probably didn't get all of the information from the MLM rep, which is a really shitty situation to be in. So let's move on to the next one. Okay, so this MLM horror story that is next is about Premier Jewelry. So it goes, hello, my name is Leslie, pronounced like Leslie. So, hey, I got it right. She said, feel free to use my name. I've been watching your channel for a long time and finally decided to share my MLM party story. This happened back in 2017 before I even knew what an MLM was or how bad they were. Finding AntiMLM videos definitely saved me from joining a few, and now I fight the good fight along with the amazing community. So moving right along, in 2017, one of my best friends won a party in a contest on a radio station. She was so excited because she'd never won anything in her life. I'm not sure how the prize was described, but it was supposed to be some lady coming over to my friend's house to talk about jewelry. Now our friend group was small, but we showed up to support her. Looking back, we were not the target guests for such a party. First up, my friend that won the party, a tomboy at heart, who doesn't even wear jewelry or even makeup for that matter, and there's nothing wrong with that. Then there was me, pretty girl, loves makeup, but not really a jewelry wearer. My wife, a stud lesbian. Our friend, Jay, who is a lot like me, girly, but not much into makeup or jewelry. Another friend, Amy, who's tomboy in a little country, and then my friend's older mother-in-law. Sorry for the book on this matter, but I want you to picture the scene. Well, my friend buys snacks and drinks, and we wait for the host, who ends up being like 30 minutes late. When she arrives, she's a middle-aged woman, and she brings her husband in tow to help bring in her display, and he stays for the party. The host gives her presentation. She has different shirts that she pairs with different necklaces to show us different way to wear the pieces. After she finishes with this, she starts talking about the starter kit and really focuses on me when pushing it. I guess because I seem like the better fit for the company compared to the other guests. I politely decline. I have a good job, and the party continues, but she mentions, quote, the opportunity, unquote, to me several times before it's over. She was saying that this could be good side money for me, and my wife and I could go on vacation, etc. None of us really want the overpriced things in the catalog the host passed around, but my friend's mother-in-law feels sorry for her and makes us each pick an item, and she paid for it. My friend, who won the party, got some free stuff for the orders. All in all, we all thought it was super lame, and my friend learned her lessons on free prizes. Sorry this is kind of long, and I know it's not juicy like other stories, but I wanted to show the lengths the Huns will go through to promote their businesses. I'm sure she paid a pretty penny to get the radio station to even do it for her. The host had gotten my email address and wrote me every few months to try and recruit me. I answered her for a while, but then just started ignoring her. Thanks for taking the time to read my story and keeping up the great work on your channel. I've been watching it grow for years and can't wait to see where it takes you. Okay, I have heard of MLMs like Beachbody promoting on radio stations, but like the MLM itself, I have never heard of an MLM rep going on a radio station and having the radio station promote a like free party thing on the radio station. Never. I learn something new every day, I tell ya. Lord, nothing will stop these MLM reps. That's for freaking sure. So I feel like that is going to be all for today's video. It is a short one, but currently this video is being pre-filmed and I have a lot of videos needing to be pre-filmed. So I thought we would do a little bit of a shorter one. Hopefully you guys are okay with that. I have some exciting content. I feel like this video is going to be posted the weekend after the trip that I go on. So I am so excited. So don't forget to leave a like and a comment. I would love to know if you guys relate to any of these stories. Have you guys ever heard of like an MLM being promoted on the radio? I've just never heard of that before. So I thought it was like really funny because it's just not something I've heard of. So don't forget to comment down below. I love chatting with you guys and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I upload every Monday and Friday, and then I do have a vlog channel. I will see you guys in the next video.